Well, you wanted hay, didn't you? Didn't they?
15? Better put this littlest one in the box. 16. Now get a bucket of water.
Water! All I do is carry water.
No force. Say, wasn't this place irrigated? I see all these flumes and ditches.
Frederick Carson turned the water off.
Frederick Carson?
He's the man who bought the ranch up above from friends who couldn't make a go of it. We had built a community dam, but it was on his property.
Well, what'd you do about it? Don't tell me. You prayed.
Of course.
Get you any water?
Well, we didn't pray for water. We prayed for Frederick Carson.
Carson turned off the water and you prayed for him?
Of course. Can't you see? By committing an evil act, the poor man injured his soul.
I'm glad there's a well. Because it'd sure get thirsty around here if we had to wait for Carson. Gonna walk this pony.
Sure, you don't leave no slack in that cinch. The boss will sure howl.
Yeah, this ain't the first pony I ever saddled. He'd squawk no matter how I done it.
You're getting mean these days, ain't he?
Cantankerous by his natural borning. That boiling his neck don't help him none either.
Get out of my way. You belong behind a plow.
Who's Carson?
Don't get down. We ain't taking on no saddle tramps on this spread. Vamoose! Are you deep? I said get moving, tramp.
Nice dam.
Yeah, what's that to you?
Take out the top two planks.
What did you say?
The top two. Let 16 inches of water over there.
Who says so?
I do.
And who might you be when you're at home?
Quirt Evans.
Well, anybody might ride up here and say they're Quirt Evans. He ain't known around here by sight. Anybody can say they're him.
Sure could.
But there's a QE stamp on his saddle.
Well, take the top planks out of that head gate, you stupid idiot. I don't need all that extra water.
Step up on that pony.
Well, now, look here, Mr. Evans. I've done what you told me to.
You sure did. Step up on that pony.
Well, I'm a kind of a fellow tries to get along with everybody.
Side me.
Well, wait a minute. Maybe we better take out a couple more of them planks, Chucks. I've got 10 times as much water as I need.
That'll do for now.
Well, if you ever need any more, Mr. Evans, all you got to do is say so.
I figured that.
Thank you.
let's start off from scratch. You got more water than you need.
You're absolutely right, Quirt. I mean, Mr. Evans. Say, do you mind if I call you Quirt?
Not a bit. So it's no skin off your moccasins if you let a little water over that ditch.
I absolutely know, Mr. Evans. I mean, Quirt.
You're gonna be neighborly or not?
Well, I sure am, Quirt.
Well, that's the way to talk.
Thomas! Frederick Koss.
Howdy, Mrs. Worth.
Oh, we always knew you'd change your mind.
Yes, ma'am. I did.
Thank you, Frederick. All of us here in the valley are grateful to you.
Worth, it's like I was saying. I ain't got any use for all that extra water. Why shouldn't I let my neighbors use it? I believe that neighbors should be friendly.
What have you got there on your neck, a boil?
Ms. Worth, I rattled that burned boil
off.
Have
you tried putting soap and sugar poultice on it?
No, ma'am, I ain't.
You get down this minute and come in the house. I'll fix it for you. That's right.
Are you going to hurt me?
No, that's a shame. It looks awful.
Well, looks like your prayer straightened everything out.
So you think your gun changed, Frederick Carson, huh?
Who says I pointed a gun?
I do.
Well, I didn't.
And he gave in more easily than I expected. They remember this, Court. The Lord moves in mysterious manner at times using strange methods and odd instruments.
Me? Mm-hmm. Well, that would be odd.
I just get a gnawing hankering after good pies and truck like that.
Oh, Freddie Carson.
Yes, sir?
I want you to have some of these. They're awful good with coffee in the morning.
Makes me want to go home and shoot my Chinese cook.
You just come back for more any time you like. There are always plenty.
Thank you.
Goodbye.
Goodbye.
Goodbye, Frederick.
Goodbye. Man ought to see more of his neighbors. Hey, wonderful woman that Mrs. Worth. Look, she fixed my boil.
Penny! Excuse me, I think Father wants to give thanks.
Oh, he already thanked me.
I know. I think now he'd like to thank someone else.
Hold my plunder while I get aboard, will you? You know, Mrs. Worth's going to keep me supplied in pies. I want to bring her over a quarter of beef now and then. Finally come to an understanding with my neighbors.
You sure did.
Oh, well, of course, you know I was just scared to death when I made that speech to them people. I'm glad you made me do it. Makes me feel good. Adios, amigo.
Dinner.
How bad's dinner gonna be?
Oh, roast venison and vegetables, and of course a skimpy chicken.
Well, with a pie and cake, I'll try to make out.
Chicken or venison?
Both. I feel real good.
Oh, you do, huh?